This conference will now be recorded.
Any other questions before starting scrolling the pages? Why do you need to scroll the pages? So what is the necessity? To scroll the pages, we're going to use and Selenium providing some concepts. And if you don't scroll, see that bottom side data, you are not going to see, right? You are not going to see bottom side data. And if you want to see the entire data, and you need to scroll. The vertical scrolling, horizontal scrolling is necessary in the tables, in the page is very big, and a lot of products are there. You want to see all the products. And if you want to see this, you need the scrolling part. So how can you scroll your web pages? So in web pages, scrolling part can be done in three ways by Selenium. It is providing three concepts. The first one is using event firing web driver class we can use to scroll the web pages. And for this, again, we are going to use execute script method. That execute script method, you have to pass the JavaScript code. Basically, this execute script method is used to execute a JavaScript code in the web driver. And this is the question. How can you execute a JavaScript code in Java Selenium? Using execute script method, you can achieve that. And this method is available in the JavaScript executor interface. Let me show you. JavaScript executor interface. There is an interface JavaScript executor. This is an interface. So this interface inside you, they declared execute script method. Execute script, and you can pass optional arguments. Execute the JavaScript in the context of currently selected frame or window, right? You can call, so your JavaScript code, and you can execute in your browser. So if you want to do that, either you can use this interface method also, execute script method. That is what we are using now here. And even in our blog, I mentioned, and this one, first way to do is, because that method is implemented in the different browser classes, right? Each browser class implemented. So one of the specially class is event firing web driver. This is one of the listener. This is one of the listener in WebDriver. So it will trigger the events and listens to all the events. And to use this event firing WebDriver, first you create a WebDriver driver equal to new Firefox driver or any browser class, you create object. Then create object for event firing WebDriver class, pass the driver reference to this object. Event firing web driver event equal to new event firing web driver driver. So this is the one we are going to use to scroll. Then this event dot, you call execute script method, then pass the JavaScript code and first argument. Second argument, you leave it blank as of now. You don't need to pass anything. If I want to scroll down, so event dot execute script window dot scroll by horizontal or vertical scroll you can give. So this window dot scroll by is a JavaScript code. Window dot scroll by is a JavaScript code. Then you can pass horizontally, you are not scrolling, so you can give a zero here, and vertical pixel. So approximately you can give pixels here if you want to scroll, right? If you want to scroll, you can give vertical pixel. So that will scroll down that many pixels, it will scroll down. And then a second argument, you leave it a blank as optional. That's how to scroll down. Then how to scroll up? Okay, you scroll down, fine. I want to scroll up. So same thing you do, event dot execute script, call the same method, window dot scroll by horizontal minus vertical, same, the whatever the pixel here you have given, just put minus the vertical pixels, it will scroll up. And second argument, you leave it to blank. So this is the one way to scroll down and scroll up in your browser. Vertically, you are scrolling down and scrolling up. Then you want to scroll down with the other way, using JavaScript executor interface. And this is the steps you need to follow. So WebDriver, driver equal to new Firefox driver, and create a variable of JavaScript executor and assign the driver variable. So see that JavaScript executor JSX equal to a driver. You typecast this driver to with the JavaScript executor interface. Why you need to typecast here? Driver is of type WebDriver interface type. WebDriver is the parent of this JavaScript executor. Now it is a type mismatch error you will get. JSX is of type JavaScript executor interface type. Driver is of type WebDriver type. So that's why you are getting a type mismatch error. Driver is and JSX both are different data types, different interface types. And what you are doing, this driver also you are converting into JavaScript executor format so that the type mismatch error will be resolved on this line. So this is what I told you in the Java also. So when I was explaining about typecasting, I explained, so you can do a typecasting on the variables, on the interfaces, on the class variables also. So anywhere you can use, you can typecast to any type. That's the typecast. If you get a type mismatch error, do a typecasting. So the problem will be solved. Next. So JSX dot execute script. Again, first argument I'm passing window dot scroll by horizontal comma vertical down. So this is the how can you scroll down. Then if you want to scroll up, call this JSX dot execute script method of window dot scroll by horizontal equals zero and minus vertical pixels equal. And second argument leave it blank. So this is the second way to scroll down and up with the JavaScript executor.
Ramesh, okay, yeah. Why the minus sign is there for scrolling up?
So you are giving a reverse, you are going up. So that's why you are giving a minus. Okay, you want to scroll up again. So that's why you are giving a reverse. So that reverse is negative sign, if you go, it will go up. So that's why we are passing a negative value for scrolling up. So this is the pixels, right? This you are starting here and you're going down. That's a positive and it is going down positive value. So when you go back, you want to go back again, you just give a negative value. So it will go up that many pixels, it will go up. So that's why we need to give a negative values to go up. So it will understand the web driver, okay, this many pixels you need to go up. So that's why we need to pass a negative value to if you want to go up. Okay. And then how can you scroll until the visibility of particular element? This is the very important for us, right? Above one, you are giving approximately pixels. We don't know where my element is there if you use above process. So this process, if you use, you don't know exactly your element came by scrolling to that extent. Then how can you scroll for particular element? And this is the one, how can you scroll for particular element visibility or until that element is present in the web piece, until that element is visible to the web driver, and you can scroll for that particular element. First, identify the web element. Right, you identify that web element, first step. How can you identify any web element? Web element, element name equal to driver dot find element by dot locator locator value. So that step you need to write. The second step, JSX dot execute script of arguments of zero dot scroll into view true semicolon. This is the entire is a JavaScript code. And give that element, which element, until which element is visible you want to scroll. So that element you identified here, that element name you pass it, automatically it will scroll down until that element is visible. So this is the one I think we are going to use many times. This process you will follow, and Because above one is you need to guess the pixels, number of pixels. That's not correct, right? We cannot guess it. And that's why most of the use cases you'll use this concept only. Okay, this is the another way to scroll per particular element. Now, is there any another way? Yes, the third one is using keys enum, you can scroll down and you can scroll up. But if you call down key and up keys, you can scroll down little bit one time, just one small, it will scroll up like this, very small, it will scroll, then scroll up one time only, it will scroll up like that. So that's the thing, it will happen with this down key and up key from the keyboard. So all these keys is an enum in the Selenium. So enum basically contains all the constants, right? That constants never going to change, that we have learned in Java already. In the collections, I explained that enum concept. And let's see, keys enum, you can see here. Keys enum, enum is the keys. So how can you access enum constants, enum name dot the constant name? Here you can see all the keyboard constants. Add, alt, arrow down key, arrow left, arrow right, arrow up. These are all the arrow down, left and right keys it is handling by this constant name. Backspace, cancel, clear, command, control, decimal, delete, divide, down. This is the one we are going to use if you want to scroll down. So end, enter, equals, escape. Any keyboard key if you want to call, you need to use send keys method. Send keys method inside, you call this constants, all these constants. Every key name is here. So how can you call enum name? Enum keys dot the constant name you can call. You can call with this enum, enum dot the constant name you can call. So that's what I'm showing here. So you have to scroll up. You can use up key to scroll up, or any tab if you want to use, you can call tab key also. If you want to press tab key, you can use this also. And we have here all that. So driver dot find element, if you want to scroll down, and driver dot find element by dot tag name, body tag. The entire page I'm scrolling down, right? That's why entire body tag I'm using. So HTML head body, the body tag I'm using. And dot send keys, keys dot down. If you want to scroll up, again call driver dot find element by dot tag name, body dot send keys, keys dot up. So any key if you want to call, this is the format. Driver dot find element by dot locator, locator value dot send keys, keys dot key name you can pass. So this is the how you can use the enum constants, how you can call. So using all these three processes, we can scroll down and scroll up the pages. Any questions before going for how to take the screenshot? I'll show you. I'll call in the same program. We'll scroll down. We'll take the screenshot so that you can observe. And all this scrolling part, and I'll show you. And then how to take the screenshot. Let me show you. We have a takes a screenshot interface is there. Take screenshot interface is there in the web driver. That takes a screenshot interface inside, you have a get screenshot as method, and that method will take the screenshot for us. And then you store in some file format, and then that file wherever you want, you can copy it in your project location, you can copy, or you can copy to your disk, any drive you can copy also. So all this text screenshot interface is implemented in all the browser classes. Each browser class it is implemented. Now, public interface takes screenshot, and this is the example how you are going to take. So indicates a driver or an HTML element that can capture a screenshot and store it in different ways. And file, screenshot file, takes a screenshot of driver dot get screenshot as, you need to give output type. Output type is an interface. And this interface inside, we have a constants. So interface contains constants, right? That constants we are calling as an argument for another method. So interface methods, how to call, I explained in Java. Interface name dot the constant name, right? So let me show you this output type interface. And this output type interface contains file, one constant, base 64, another constant, and one more we have byte format also. You can get the screenshot. So let me show you this. So this interface, see that? So interface output type, this is the generic type, any type you can pass. T is the type for the screenshot output. Now see that these are the fields, constants. Any this type format, you can pass it to get screenshot as method. See, the one interface fields you are passing as an argument to the method. So that's the code we are going to use. See that get screenshot as output type you need to pass. And that we can store anywhere. That I have given very clearly here with the code. Let me give you the same code we are using even in the WebDriver also. WebDriver framework, we are using same code. How to take the screenshot. And this is the one. And I written a simple method, but it's not the simple method. Let me give you the exact method what we are going to use so that it will be easy for us. The screenshots also I'm capturing here. So I just created a private static void capture a screenshot and a string screenshot name we are giving. String screenshot name. So you can give your own screenshot name. You can pass at runtime your screenshot name. That's a parameterized method we are creating. And this is the file. File type I am passing. Take screenshot of driver dot get screenshot as output type dot file. And then what I'm doing here is I'm creating object for a date class, date d equal to new date, so that I'm generating the dynamic screenshot. Every time you run, it should not be the same name, so it will change every time, right? So that you won't get any problem the file creation. And new date, and you can pass the screenshot name hyphen hyphen d dot to string dot. These are all string methods I am calling. In my date, I am getting a date. How I am getting it is here. Let me show you that format. How I am going to get a date. So I'll create one rough program in our. So just. Let me create. I think I explained this again. I'm giving one more time. So rough work. So take this. So let me take this code, entire code. So what it is giving, I just want to show you that I am formatting. I'm just formatting that. Right. Just print d dot to string. See that what format you are getting. Just execute this. What is the output you got? Thursday, Jan 21:08, :, and some spaces. Maximum you have a spaces, right? Spaces are there, and then colons are there. I need to format this. How can you format? So I need to replace all these things. I'll put a hyphen or underscore, whatever I want. So that's what I'm doing here. Replace method. First, I converted into two string format this date object. So that's a d dot two string. So I got a string object, string dot replace method. I'm replacing the colon with the underscore. Then on with this, you will get one more string. On that one more string, so what I'm doing, I'm replacing the spaces with underscore and plus dot JPEG format I want. So that's the one idea. So this file utils class, we need this file utils class if you want to use. And can you see here org.apache.commons.io? This jar file you need to download. So can you all download this quickly, that jar file? You go to Maven repository. So Maven repository, just go to Maven repository. So Maven repository. Right, Maven repository. This is the mvnrepository.com. Go to this website, just type commons. I will just search this. So the first one, Apache Commons IO. So see that what this is providing. The Apache Commons IO library contains utility classes, stream implementations, file filters, file comparators, Indian transformation classes, and much more. So now to copy the file, the file utils class is available under this jar file. So that's why I'm downloading 2.8.0. And here you have the jar. You just click on this jar, it will download. Then you need to add this jar to our project. In hybrid framework, we are going to add this Maven dependency. But in the independent Java WebDriver project, you have to add the jars, right? How we did Selenium jars, we download and we added. The same way, any other utility classes, if you want to use that utility jar file, you need to add to your project. Then you can use those utility classes in your program. Otherwise, we cannot use it. So that's the reason we need to do that. To copy this screenshot into my project path, I need this. File utils dot copy file, and this is the source file. I'm copying into new file system.get property user.dir. This will give us the current project directory. What the system.get property will give? This will give you the current project directory. This project directory it will give. So I don't need to hard code my project name. So if you give this, see that D Eclipse Workspace WebDriver Training Java WebDriver Training Jan 7, 2021. So this entire path it will give you automatically where you are working, current project, the current project directory it will give. That's what I did here. That is what I am doing here. See that? That then I'm appending where I want my screenshot. SRC. Screenshot folder I am creating plus this screenshot name I am passing. This the customized screenshot name I'm passing here. I'm appending. Just appending to this folder, all the screenshots will place it under this screenshot folder. How many times you call that method will take the screenshot and place it under this screenshot folder. This is what we are doing. The same thing I have given here also. That's what we are doing here. So this is the same thing I did here also, right? Screenshot, right? You can pass the same method, but I'm passing a screenshot name. So as a method, so you have to take one parameter. That parameter you can pass it. So that's all about how to take the screenshot, how to scroll the pages. Tomorrow we'll finish quickly this coding. So then